endureth forever. He has caused his wonders to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and he is compassionate. He provides food for those who fear him. He remembers their covenant, his covenant forever. He has shown his people the power of his works, given them lands on other nations. The works of his hand are faithful and just, and his precepts are trustworthy. Amen. God's word for God's people. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise when we see the choir. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Anybody in here? Praise the Lord, everybody. Thank you.
I'm still waiting for you, I got you. Thank you. stay in the
together for Jesus.
Come on, come into song right now. Come on, lift up the voices of heaven. The Lord who is. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The one that woke me up this morning. Out of the song that way. My God.
Yes.
We thank God for being in the house. When I approached the grounds, I felt the anointing of God.
Come on, yes.
When I entered the threshold through the door, I heard the Lord say, something is going to happen.
Yes.
But you just got to be ready.
Yes.
And I walk in and I see my good friend over here, Dominique. He was playing the organ at first, and he said, the organist is on the way. So I said, I play drums for a little bit. And he said, the organist just came in the door. And I said, where'd he go? He said, he's coming around. And he comes around the corner. And I said, it's my brother, Darrell. So I said, well, Lord, what you doing? Because these two young brothers are talented.
Yes, they are.
And then you join me together in the same place as them. And I said, whatever you're about to do, I'm ready for whatever mighty move that you're about to make. And then I said, okay. So then when it came to a loving and showing care for the visitors, I was walking around, and I walked around this way, and I stopped and spoke with Mother. And before then, God already gave me a song. And I said, well, Lord, just grant me confirmation of what you want me to sing.
Uh-huh.
And she said, God is good. I said, yes, he is. She said, I've seen good days and I've seen bad days. And she said, I am 94 years old.
Right, yeah.
94 years old. And that touched my spirit because she said she was the oldest of all of her siblings. And she said it was 6 brothers and 3 sisters.
Amen.
And she said she was the oldest and none of them are living. I said none of them are living, but she's the only one that's here. And I said, well, God, well, I thank you for the confirmation. So the song that God has given me is I Won't Complain.
Oh, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some windy days. And some sleepless nights. But when I look around and I think things all over, all of my good days, how am I finding? For I will complain. Sometimes the clouds are low. I can hardly see the road. I ask a question, Lord. Why so much pain? But you know. Oh,
eyes, they can't see. Oh, so I say, thank you, Lord. So I just say, thank you, Lord. So I just say, thank you, Lord. So I just say, thank you, Lord. I've been tired of, but I thank you, Lord. I've been talking about, but I thank you, Lord. You listen to you, but I still thank you, Lord.
I'm That you may be, But you still belong to the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Father God, now we thank you and we bless your holy name for that you're getting ready to do in this place. God, I pray one more time, God, that you would come now and increase this sick man and you increase him. Oh, God, bring the Holy Ghost alive because I believe somebody needs you right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, God. God, I pray victory now to every person in this building this afternoon, God, that something from somewhere will make him brand new. And Father God, I pray that you will rebuke that which is not of you, God. You will do what you did in this building, in this house, in this church. God, set it free right now. Heal right now, God, as you can only heal. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen.
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 And amen. Amen. Come on and clap those hands and tell the Lord thank you. Tell the thank you for being to us. Thank you for what you're ever learning to do. Thank you, God. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Lord. Let us go now to the 8th chapter of Romans and see what the Lord has in store for this house. Yes, Lord. God is good and all the time. God is good. Let's look at verses first now through the 8th verses of that said text. Read those from the hell if you would.
There is therefore no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life is Christ Jesus, have made free from the law of sin and death.
Mm-hmm.
For what the law could not do, that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for the sin, condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For they that are after the flesh do not do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnal-minded is death, but not to be spiritual-minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not the subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God.
Amen.
But you are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. If indeed the Spirit of God dwells in you. Now, if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is not his. And if Christ is in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead, dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to you, mortal bodies, through his Spirit who dwells in you. Now, certainly when you're eating the Holy Ghost, I want to talk for a few minutes on this subject under new management. That's what I want to talk about. If God has done anything for you, you ought to have something to say. If God has brought you out of anything, you are a stone of have a testimony in your belly. If God has broken what it used to be and gave you some new ground, you ought to be seeing some new stuff. I can't hear nobody. If God has
has brought you out of the muck and the moderate clay and set your feet on a solid foundation. You ought to be glorifying God with the Spirit of God. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
What's going here? Under new management. See, the reason you had to find yourself a new manager, the old manager just wasn't getting it. The old devil continued to visit you. The old devil continued to train your mind. The old devil continued to put stuff in your heart. The old devil continued to break what God has blessed you with. The old devil continued to come to your heart and begin to mix you up and confuse you and try to tell you that there is no hope for you. But once you told that rapper, listen, I no longer belongs to you. I now belong to Jesus Christ. I no longer belongs in your society. I'm no longer in the club anymore. I'm no longer in the game anymore. I'm under a new manager.
Amen.
His name is Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
You can just testify that long enough. Oh, you see life going in the right direction, and well, flesh won't be as important anymore as it used to be, and you began to deal with the Spirit of God, Paul tells the Romans, he says, you got to, Paul said, you got to identify, with the struggle of common men and women. He knows that when we can get trapped, he knows that the enemy can't use you until he trap you. He can't use you until he get in your mind, buddy. He can't use you until he turn you around. He can't do anything with you until you find something to agree with him on. He can't use because the devil has no power.
Hey.
Oh, he's an intimidator.
Yes.
Intimidates the God spirit in you and try to take you where you don't need to be and carry you where you don't need to go. Anybody here this morning? Huh? Paul said, he'll trap you, he'll confuse you, and he'll put you in a position where right is no longer right. He'll have you unable to follow the Spirit of God. He'll have you frustrated. He'll have you seeking that don't even exist. He'll tell you stuff that's not even true. All he wants to do is get in your mind. If you can get in your mind, brother, you become more confused than ever before. I just believe you can't identify with a new manager until you clear your mind, until you take your mind out of it and put your mind on Jesus. You really can't benefit from the power of God until you are able to sell yourself down and say, look at here, I got a father who cares about me. I got a father who cares for me. I got a father who has delivered me. I got a father who has broken all the curses in my life and has placed my feet on a solid foundation. Anybody here? Paul says here, who do not walk accordingly to the flesh, but accordingly to the Spirit. In other words, what you go through with really don't matter. Because God is greater than everything you go through with. Paul just simply said, don't worry about your daily choices.
Right.
Don't worry about the daily activity.
Yeah.
Look at the Spirit of God and make your home in the Spirit of God. Don't worry about the flesh. Don't worry about what the flesh do or don't do. Just stay in tune with the Spirit. Because the Spirit will outlast any situation or circumstance you may be attached to. You got to tell yourself, you got to make sure yourself believe that and know that, so God can deliver you and keep you free indeed.
Amen.
Anybody free?
Amen.
Well, Jesus was a very unique Savior. As we are going into the season, and this being the Sunday before Easter, and understanding the reason for all of Jesus' turmoil during this time of the crucifixion. See, Jesus really didn't have to go through. He could have very well came to this earth and really been one of us, but he came as one of us. But he could not be one of us. He came looking like you and I. He came going through choices in life, but he was different. Now he knew that he had to save you and I. And as you began to dive into this season, I want you to understand it's all about the presence of God. And every time you take the presence of God, place it in your heart, a resurrection become important to you, and you can understand why God sent his only son, why God brought his only son to go through turmoil. See, we're worried about what we go through it, but can none of us go through it, but Jesus went through it. You want to say, thank you, Lord, and I've been redeemed, and I've been changed because of the presence of God. So you got to understand whatever God has allowed you to go through with, it ought to be well with your soul. You ought to be all right in knowing that I'm in the presence of God. See, we worry too much. We worry too much about what tomorrow is going to be. We worry too much about it ain't like it used to be. We worry too much. There's a reason God have you where you are. But what you need to do is thank God that I'm where I am because of his grace and mercy. None of us really deserve the grace and mercy of God. Because the story was really told about all of us. We wouldn't even be sitting there. But because of God's grace and mercy, he forgave you and I that we would be alright. See, it was Jesus who first took the form to be a servant. See, a servant is that person that don't mind working anywhere we are and making everything you need for the cause of Christ. I don't know about you, but first of all, we got to learn how to live like this. We got to learn how to live like Christ. Be like Christ. In other words, we got to position ourselves as the Creator has brought us, and God made man in his own image. He didn't just make no joke, but he made us in his own image that we will be servants unto him. Whatever God have you, you better learn how to be grateful in the presence of God. I don't care about your struggles. That ain't it. That's just a stage to be a servant unto the Lord. Somebody else says, thank you, Holy Spirit. And it is all right in my life. Secondly, I want you to look at this text and really understand what Paul is trying to tell the Romans here. In that sixth verse, it said, for to be carnal mind is dead, but to be spiritual minded is life and peace. See, the reason people go through what they go through with Sister Queen, they have no peace. See, when you don't have no peace, your mind struggles, your mind wonders, you need to start lying on one another. And when you don't have no peace, you will say anything. You will do anywhere. You will do anything. You will tell anything except the truth. Somebody will say, you better learn to live and experience of God. Learn how to live and experience of God. You don't worry about God. The struggles, you began to say, God's gonna make a way. Anyhow, never gonna see you come.
God's gonna heal me. I'm holy me. You learn how to live in the spirit. He's a go home with you. He's a wait with you. He's a sleep with you. He's a talk to you. And give you a hand. He's a man. All I know, God says, you better shake yourself. Shake yourself. Fix yourself. See about yourself. Stop worrying. Stop being living. Take care of yourself. Be a servant. I'm coming on. And the Lord will. I'm still about you. Doesn't matter what shape you need. Doesn't matter what you've been doing. But all I know, and I'm serving God. Your mess is the enemy to God.
Yes.
Sitting around block.
Yes.
Trying to trip somebody. Because
yes.
It look like they're getting what you can't get. They're doing what you can't do.
All right.
That's the enemy to God.
Yes.
Paul said, y'all be careful. Know that you're known for. It is not a subject to the law of God, not indeed can be. So then those who are in the flesh cannot please God. In other words, God is not worried about the flesh because he got a prepared place for a prepared people.
Amen. Come on.
And I yet still believe heaven starts right here.
Amen. Amen.
Yes,
amen.
So heaven starts right here, Brother Leon. Yes, when I get to heaven, I'm going to sing. You better start singing now.
Amen.
When I get to heaven, I'm going to wear my robe. You're going to wear it here. The heaven may not fit.
All right now.
I'm going to walk around him alone, but he's going to walk now. Because you just may not know how to walk when you get there.
All right.
And see, practice make what perfect. I can't hear nobody. What a love. See, I yet believe until God forgives you.
Yes.
You're still the same devil. Until you and God communicate. God sets you free. Then you're able to walk with your brothers and your sisters. And walk around heaven all day. You can't walk around heaven all day with malice in your heart. You can't walk without loving one another. You're going to have to tell me I love you, baby.
Yeah.
Even if you got to do it with a hung down head. And then the no eye contact, you still ain't getting no forgiveness from God. So you worry about forgiving from each other. Don't worry about each other. Getting from God and then love one another. Whoa, love yourself. Everybody don't know what you know.
Yeah.
All right.
You think mother know what you think? Oh, she really don't care. He does, but she don't care. She is going to keep on smiling.
That's right. Amen.
Oh, you remember what you said, baby? I don't know nothing I said to you. Whatever it was. You need to do is talk to God and move on.
That's right.
And he will.
Yes,
well. Make everything all right with it. Some stuff you cannot fix
peace with your brothers and your sisters.
All right.
I just said, God can fix it. But some stuff we cannot fix. Clear yourself and move on.
Amen.
Because if you're holding on to it, that means you can't fix it.
Right.
Somebody write that book for me. So if it was fixed, then you wouldn't think about it every day.
Yes. That's right.
Come on, Paul. Talk to him.
Amen.
Talk to him.
That's right.
But you are not in the flesh.
Yeah.
Hello.
But in the spirit. You're always in the spirit.
Amen.
That's why Paul said you can't hang around in the flesh trying to fix somebody that don't want to be fixed.
Right. Amen.
Trying to change somebody that don't want to be changed.
Amen.
You can all migraine because they won't listen to you.
Amen.
The devil is a liar.
Yes. Yes.
Well, she used to be my friend. Well, used to mean past tense. Anything past tense should be done. I say this all the time, because we linger in fields we ain't got no business lingering in. The fields are all grown up. You got no way to cut them. You just hide in the field because of your own feelings. Even though I say guilt. Your own guilt got you hanging out in an unknown field. But tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, let's come out of those fields. And watch God bless you. Go in the common. Paul said here, he said that Christ is in you. The body is dead because of sin. Which means he's telling you to stop acknowledging the flesh that you have. And praises unto God where he is. But don't let the world keep you handicapped because of who they thought you used to be. So Paul is saying that was flesh. But since you come into the safety of God, God has given you a new arena. He's given you a new dance. He's given you a new shout. He's given you a new song. He's given you a new home since you've come out. That's why you can say, I'm under new management. And when you find yourself under new management, you begin to brag as to what God has given you. Testify. Oh, I don't have to think that way anymore. I don't have to live that way anymore. Because I'm under new management. And since I'm under new management, Brother Sugar Babe, I can do a new thing. I can go to new places, Mother. And not worry about where I am. Not worry about my back. My spirit is going along with me. And I invite the Lord to show me where you want me. I've asked the Lord to show me where to go and how to stand. Because I don't know about you, but I hold the voice of the Lord say, Jesus was in the form of God. In other words, God changed his son to himself. Not for him, as a God, for you and I. God did just bring him there. Because he wanted a son, and he brought him there. Because Jesus was a perfect man. He brought him there. But you know, he only made one. I gave him the authority to call the enemy out of everyone.
I come here this afternoon to tell you that it's time to be Christ-like. It's time to give up the ghost. It's time to stop playing games and you to fail on the new medicine. The old habits can't be no more. The old one reminder can't say no more. Whatever it used to be, it is no more. You have anybody, you love the Lord enough to know that Jesus, he died, we must die to our sins, and let the Holy Ghost bring us back under the new management. I'm hunting with that balloon, and I swear to you, the Lord, I glorify the Lord in this house. You are so long, Lord, thank you. I'm going this morning, I will bring you to life. See if you can ever experience the feeling of that spirit. Oh, your life will never be the same. Listen, I don't care what it took to get you to where. It doesn't matter. You could have been X, Y, Z, Z. It's where you are right now.
Yes.
Let no devil tell you that God has not delivered you.
Right.
And given you a new attitude. Right. Don't ever tell you that.
Hallelujah.
The Lord will.
Yes. Yes.
Do it.
Yes.
And as I close this message, verse 28 says, and we know that all things work together for the good to those who love God, to those that are called, and listen, this is an accordingly to his purpose. Listen, you can't get anything from your purpose in the ears to me. Something got to go. That's why we become confused in the church. But I can't have my way.
All right, come on.
But I can't do what I know of it. It's his purpose.
Yes.
Of whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be firstborn among many brethren.
Jesus.
In other words, you got to be born again.
Amen.
He's already telling you what you came as ain't gonna work. Another crying baby ain't gonna work no more. A baby with a bottle ain't gonna work no more. 40 years old, you're still in the box.
All right.
Ain't working no more.
Yeah, my gosh.
Of
according to his purpose. Well, how am I going to discover his purpose? The Holy Ghost will tell you. But he cannot tell you if he don't know you. He won't tell you if he don't know you. You got folk been in church 40 years. They ain't experienced the Holy Ghost yet.
Hallelujah.
It's a tearing up the church.
Come on, Bishop.
Got little groupies in the church.
Yes, Bishop.
All of them throwing the same thing.
Yes.
But baby, when you've been born again and you know you're free in the Holy Ghost, oh, you got something going on. You don't have to worry about mistakes. You don't have to worry about attitudes. You don't have to worry about ignorance.
Amen.
Jesus.
Thank you,
Holy Ghost. You can say, I know I've been changed. We bless you for this message, God. God, we bless you for that you've done here on today, God. I pray healing in this house, God. I pray victory in this house, God. I pray miracles in this house, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, you do it, God. Oh, Father God, we thank you. God, we bless every portion of you. And God, we thank you now. As we come up under new balance, that everything is well. and everything is all right. And in Jesus' name, amen. 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 Come on, clap those hands. Come on, clap those hands.